In this segment, we're going to talk about Gauss elimination with partial pivoting, which is a way to find solution to simultaneous linear equations. And we are right now talking about an example. And of course, in this example, we are using something special. We're using five significant digits with chopping for all of our intermediate as well as final calculations. So having said that, this is what we obtained at the end of the forward elimination steps. So the example is requiring us to now conduct the back substitution step. So this is what we obtained at the end of the forward elimination steps for this example. We had 20, 15, 10, 0, minus 2.75, 0.5, 0, 0, 8.5, 0, 0, 1, x of 1, x of 2, x of 3, and we had 45, minus 2.25, and 8.5, 0, 0, 1. So what we want to be able to do is we want to be able to use our back substitution steps. So we have to show the back substitution steps for this example. But again, keep in mind that all the back substitution steps which we have to show is that they have to follow this rule of five significant digits with chopping, that all intermediate as well as final calculations have to be done with five significant digits with chopping. So let's go and do the back substitution. What that means is that we'll have to take the last equation, then the second last equation, the third last equation, and so on and so forth to be able to calculate our constants, to be able to calculate our solution vector. So the last equation is 8.5001 x of 3 is equal to 8.5001. So I get x of 3 is equal to 8.5001 divided by 8.5001. And that turns out to be 1. Yeah, surely I can show all the significant digits which I was supposed to show, but I'm just not showing them for purposes of keeping things a little bit clean. But you can understand that if I need to show all the significant digits, then I do show them. Now, x of 2, in order to calculate x of 2, we have minus 2.75 x of 2 plus 0.5 x of 3 is equal to minus 2.25, right? So we have that. So what that does mean, x2 is equal to minus 2.25 minus 0.5 x3 divided by minus 2.75. And that value turns out to be minus 2.25 minus 0.5 times 1 divided by 2.75. So keep in mind that I have to show each intermediate calculation has to be also done with five significant digits. That's why I'm not just simply putting these numbers in a calculator and telling you what the answer is. So I have to do minus 2.25 minus 0.5. So I need to do this multiplication first, divided by 2.75, minus 2.75. And then I will do this addition first, so I get minus 2.75 divided by minus 2.75. And now I will do the division, and I get 1 for x of 2. So that's what I get as the value of x of 2. So now let's go and see what x of 3 is. That will be obtained from the third last equation, which in this case is the last first equation. So I get 20x1 plus 15x2 plus 10x3. Is equal to 45. So x1, the way the equation is going to be written is 45 minus 15x2 minus 10x3 divided by 20. So I get 45 minus 15 times 1 minus 10 times 1 divided by 20, because those are the values which I obtained for x2 and x3. So what I'll do is I'll do the multiplications first. I get 45 minus 15 minus 10 divided by 20. And then I'll subtract 45, subtract 15 from 45 first. I get 30 minus 10 divided by 20. Then I do the 30 minus 10. I get 20 divided by 20, and I get equal to 1. So the solution which I get by using the back substitution for this problem with five significant digits with chopping, I get x1, x of 2, x of 3 is equal to 1, 1, and 1. And that, in fact, is the exact solution. So keep in mind that we are illustrating this example to show that how we can reduce round-off error. In this case, the round-off error got reduced totally, but that's just a coincidence. So please don't think that when you're going to use Gauss elimination partial pivoting that you will be able to reduce the round-off error to zero. That's not the case. In this case, it turns out that's just a coincidence. And that's the end of this segment.